The handle is @KevinFromWorkTV.
Correct.
Wow. I can't believe that. All right, let me get my papers
right
here. So, Jordan.
Yep.
Yeah.
I should stay over here, right?
Yeah. Jordan was born in El Paso, where at the age of 5, it seems to be about 10 years ago, I'm sure.
She, no, I ain't right.
Yeah, exactly. She began performing in local plays, voiceovers, local commercials. Jordan is no stranger to comedy for the Disney family. Did you see this little like wine cup they have, by the way? I'm sorry. It's just like, it's so amazing. Sorry. It just a little thought just comes to me. Her first role was at Disney Channel's original movie, Go Figure. From which she then scored the role of Kelsey Grammer's daughter on the ABC sitcom Hank.
Yeah,
was it interesting?
Yeah.
Right? Was that? Did you do that? Yeah. Additional television credits include guest star role on Dirt, CSI Miami, made for TV movie, The Mother's Rage, Glass House, Good Mother, that's the one with Angie Harmon.
Yeah.
That was a good one. Jordan also made, and we all think I loved it, an indelible impression as a mafioso's daughter on a Gary Harold and Kumar 3D Christmas.
Yep.
As well as 5 seasons as Miss Dynamics on Sci-Fi's hit Eureka. While not acting, Jordan is typically writing screenplays. Really?
Yeah.
And contemplating her next tattoo.
Well,
That's
16 now. Let's stop.
Yeah, exactly. Matt, where'd Matt go?
Out of this.
Hello, Matt. How are you? Hello, Matt. Matt plays Brian.
Whoops.
With Kevin's friend. Matt is a Detroit native.
Yeah.
Yes, hey.
thank you.
You don't get that a lot.
I know. Yeah. No, not here.
Not anywhere.
Previously starred for 2 seasons as new rookie Duncan Moore on ABC's hit series, Rookie Blue. As well as a recurring role on the CW LA Complex and on Vice TV's comedic series Guidance.
Yeah.
That's correct. Additionally, Matt has guest starred on NBC's The Firm as well as USA series Suits. Matt currently resides in Los Angeles.
Yes, I do.
I'm so happy. Yeah. Oh, good. I'm glad. Where is Matt Rogel?
Jason,
thank you. I told you I needed your help. Yeah, I know. It's his birthday today. Yeah. He plays Ricky. When he's on film, he's incredibly watchable. He's a wonderful, wonderful guy, and he just directs a lot of attention. He's a Southern California native from Long Beach.
Yeah,
right?
ABC.
He's not new to ABC family. He was in the state of Georgia.
Uh-huh.
And in the Mistletoe movie, alongside Tori Spelling. Poonam Patel. Thank you. She plays Patty, a lover. She's Audrey's roommate. She was born in Vero Beach, Florida.
That's my credit. Oh, I'm right now.
You swam, played lacrosse there?
I did.
Yeah, look at me. You got some things on you. She went to Chicago, where she was a sketch comedian and an improv actor at Second City.
Yeah.
We're glad you're here. Do you live here?
I do live here.
What's your address? You can go over there.
I'm in historic Filipino town.
Oh, there you go. She plays Audrey Kevin Geldingtrust. Now this really amazes me because it really still happens. Even though traps, candy store isn't here anymore, dreams still do come true in Hollywood. And Paige will tell you. This is Paige over the debut.
Yeah.
I found some things Washington, Pennsylvania.
Oh my gosh!
I know, it's very, very bizarre.
I'm never happy.
General Custer's great-great-great-grandson. That's Steel Country, for those of you who don't know. It's about an hour south of Pittsburgh, right?
Holy
yeah,
shit.
I know. How about this? She attended the Point Park Theater Conservatory in Pittsburgh, right?
Oh my god, I thought you were talking about your friend's daughter. Like, what?
You can't make this stuff up, right? Yeah, good. Then she moved to New York City, where she attended Marymount Manhattan College and continues her performing arts training there for a while. Then she moved to Los Angeles, and I think you were here, correct?
No.
Good. Noah.
It's gonna be long. Get comfortable, everybody.
So, spawned from the country that brought us Ryan Gosling, Ryan Reynolds, Jim Carrey, my favorite, Neil Young. Noah is one of Canada's most versatile young actors. Thank you. Noah recently starred in the series Backpackers from CW and has appeared on Cracked, Elvis, 3 Inches, The Firm, Rookie Blue, They Know Each Other. It was one of the leads of ABC's miniseries Titanic. Film credits include Pride of Blind, Old Stop, and Score, a hockey musical.
That's right. It's the only one. Highest grossing hockey musical of all time.
On stage? On stage, Noah recently starred in Predator and performed both as a musician and an actor in A Woman is a Secret. Also starred in the Canadian premiere of Dead Medical, as well as other theatrical credits, including Red, Jitters, Pompoomery, Trespassers, Three Sisters, and my favorite, he portrayed Chip in Disney's Beauty and the Beast. Noah is a graduate of the National Theatre School of Canada and is classically trained in piano and casually plays the guitar and accordion, and he is my future son-in-law. No!
He was the voice of Franklin and Guy.
Wow.
Airbnb? Anybody got a room?
This Q&A is very informal, so we kind of, I have some prepared questions, and we're going to start with you. What is really at the core Kevin from Work about?
I think it's kind of about figuring out what you want. You know, young people have to figure that out for themselves, and in Kevin's case, he's seen a job that he doesn't like, you know, but he's got great friends. He's obviously got a handful of a sister whose heart is in the right place, and what he really wants is the love of this woman who kind of like lives across the cubicle from him, and he's scared to go get it because he's not the most confident. I think people, you know, often feel like the thing, the person or the thing they want is just out of reach, and that's certainly the case for him. And it just takes a little help from the booze to get you going. It's not a life lesson, people.
Paige, talk about the character.
Very genuine, good friend to men and women in her life, and she puts them first for the most part before she puts herself. And you know, we kind of see her at the point of her life where she's in her mid-20s, and she knows exactly who she is, who she wants to be, where she wants to go within her job, and then this letter really challenges her to question all that she worked so hard to know, and which is a little scary, and at first she wants nothing to do with that, you know, because she's comfortable where she is. Mm-hmm. And you'll see later on, and you know, as the episode air, she slowly kind of caves in. You know, it's just a huge challenge right now, and
good.
She's very vulnerable.
How many episodes?
10.
Yeah. Matt. What else did I miss?
Mr. Lyons.
Lyons!
Bleed blue. The red
wings. Yeah. Red wings as well. Bleed red and blue.
Yeah.
Okay.
I have a question for him. I don't say it yet. Matt, what did you learn about Lyons?
The emotions, how emotional he is and how quickly he changes those emotions. He'll go from excited to sad to happy to angry. You know, he just goes, he literally lives in the moment and then the next moment at the same time.
That was
so fast.
That's all
disaggregate
thinking.
That's a big word. I don't know.
Things we all think every day, but put it into a person who has the confidence, whether it's valid or not, to say it all the time. That's her. So it's kind of, she's crazy, but in a way it's inspiring that she's so flawed but thinks she's perfect. And I mean, all of us, especially women, we all have a little bit of crazy in us, so it was fun to not suppress it and just let it live. Jordan,
yeah.
My older daughter is Jenna, he would know of, but my young daughter is very scary. Very. Is Jamie here?
Are you trying something with your daughter?
No.
Crazy in all these characters. Everyone, I mean, we're all like
people are going to relate to everything. I mean, my character Ricky is like the chismoso, like gossip monger of the office. He's in everybody's business, and it's, I mean, who doesn't know that aunt or that? Adorable, gorgeous, all of it.
Thank you. Watch the show. Okay, so I have one last question. It's for everybody. On a personal note, has this ever happened to you at work, or you could crush on somebody and maybe act it on a little bit? Sort of this character and this project that sort of drew you in besides
getting the job and all that. Working very busy again.
Well, you know, most of the stuff I've done has been in Canada, and you know, I've never been on a television show in the States. I've never played the title character aside from Franklin the Turtle. I was nine, so that doesn't quite.
But I feel
like this script is about kind of, you know, figuring out who you are and taking a risk, and that I think speaks to everybody, and I love playing a character that is the everyman that everybody can kind of relate to, like, oh man, I've said things that made me feel stupid, and I've not gone through it when maybe I should have, and all of that stuff. And I think it's a really human story. It's a story that relates to young people. It's funny as hell. You know, like, I've seen this show like 3-4 times and still cracking up.
So,
you know, that's a great, it seems to get better every time I watch it, and I can't wait to see what happens next.
Yeah, I did reference her. McGee actually was just like, you know, like Snow White would with her animal. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Like, also, like 500 Days of Summer, too. Like, still play it cool. And I was like, got it. I don't want to do that. It took me a while to, like, walk, like, constantly in the bar while everyone was looking at me with big birds. And, like, the prop guy with the whole band. And I was like, but really, does this look good?
The best thing was that when they were like, you know, Paige is like walking in slow motion, and they're like, okay, action, and Paige starts like kind of like walking in slow motion. Like, cut. You don't actually have to walk.
Journey on flying here, and
we flew down together to shoot the pilot, and we got lost in the airport. And it was great team building.
Every time we're like we think one another knows what we're doing, neither of us do.
We're just walking in the same direction, talking, like, great assuming that the other guy knows where he's
going.
And then eventually, I say, "Wait, no, do you know what we're supposed to do?" He's like, "No, not at all. I thought you did." I'm like, "Let's go back." And then we stayed in the same hotel and everything. We called each other's rooms, houses. I'm like, I'm gonna go to your house before we go to bed. And then, you know, Poonam had like this big showcase the day after we all met. So we all went to her showcase after the reading and everything. So, yeah. And we hung out like constantly between the time that the pilot was shot and the time that we started filming again. All of us did, so except for him, we went back to Canada land.
Sure.
But we sent him a lot of messages.
We did. That's true.
A lot of videos.
A lot of love.
On my birthday, I got like a 20-minute video. These people screaming in a restaurant.
We celebrated it here.
I was like, we gotta sing.
I am not sexually aggressive.
Jordan, how about you?
I think me and Roxy both have like a lot of spontaneity. Her a little more so than me. But you know, the way she like moved to LA on a whim feels kind of like what I did. Even though she like kind of took over her brother's entire apartment. I don't know. I think that would be it. She's just always, I mean, everything always worked out for her, which, you know, might not necessarily be everyone's story, but she definitely, like, she has that spontaneity that I really appreciate, that I try and do for the most part. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Great hair.
Thank you.
Beautiful. Really beautiful.
Hey,
do you want to answer?
Sure. I think what I mostly relate to with Audrey is, I knew exactly who I was at 18, 19, 20, and 21, and then when I hit around, 24, 25 is when just my world changed. I was changing all of a sudden. I didn't know who I wanted to be, who I wanted to love, how I wanted to love, and where I wanted to go with my life. And that's really scary because you think it would be the opposite, and you kind of find that at 25, 26, you start to see that. And so what I love about Audrey, she's right there, and I can relate to that because I'm going through it. And I just think it's really relatable, and it's really scary and challenging, and and I love finding that with her.
Shame. A lot of shame and embarrassment and discomfort. I mean, I'm a Gemini, and so I think the other 50% of me thinks that I'm great. There's definitely, I think that Kevin probably has the same thing, where some days he's like, yeah, Kevin, you're hitting it. You're doing good work here, buddy. Good job, Kevin. And then the next day he's like, oh, Kevin, idiot.
I think Kevin attacks himself too, and
he's out loud.
Yeah.
For me, I think it's, I like to inspire people a lot. Except I know how to word it a little better than Ryan. I like to help my friends as much as possible, and he's very dedicated, to his friends, and he goes up and beyond. But Brian messes it up. I mess it up sometimes, but for the most part, I get it right. So I kind of have that in common with Brian, just my dedication to friends and trying to inspire, people. Hope that inspires you.
Well, the letter comes first, he's got to get the letter in hand. He would have to go back into the room to get his clothes.
My brownie ice. And
the food stuffs. Yeah. Once the food stuffs had been delivered and the clothes had been recovered, I think there would have been a clever, sorry, gotta go, exit. That is my hope. I don't know. I mean, I think that he certainly thinks that he knows her very well. They've been working together probably, what, 4 years or so?
Three years
or so in the same place. You passed. I think that there are some people that you kind of, be it in a work situation or whatever, that you kind of get to know quite quickly, and I think that Audrey is somebody who gives off a very pure kind of aura. She has a way about her that he just feels that he understands. And that's, I don't know. Then maybe that's a better question for you. How well do you think Kevin understands Audrey?
Right in the door.
Oh boy.
All the time. All you guys Oh, he just did this to me earlier. A high five. Anyway, letting that go. I think he knows Audrey better than she knows herself right now. I think he sees her potential of, the kind of woman she wants to be and the kind of love she deserves. And I think he sees that and sees it before she ever thought of herself in that way. So.
He's a romantic too, so he sees the best, right? He sees the best in her.
I got a question.
For Paige? Just generally? Oh, for now.
Why don't you see romantic animals around me? You have the best